If you compress Earth's entire timeline into a single year, then humans showed up on December 31st at about 11:30 p.m. In other words, we're basically brand new to this planet, and yet, in our brief time here, which spans roughly 300,000 years, the world has transformed dramatically. And if you could travel back to when our species first emerged, you would encounter creatures that seem almost fictional today. But what exactly would these early humans have faced? When Homo sapiens first appeared, they were confined to Africa and remained there for tens of thousands of years, not venturing far until modern humans finally spread outward around 60,000 to 70,000 years ago. Or at least, that's the migration whose descendants went on to populate the globe. During this extended period of staying put in Africa, our ancestors would have crossed paths with numerous environments and, more significantly, creatures that no longer exist today. That thankfully, or unfortunately, depending on your perspective, aren't around anymore. Immediately, you might picture things like mammoth-sized beasts, prehistoric predators, and other Ice Age giants. And while such animals did exist elsewhere, they weren't what early humans encountered. And actually, many of these famous prehistoric creatures either never inhabited Africa or had vanished from the continent before we came along. Instead, Africa followed its own evolutionary path, with extinct species that looked remarkably similar to modern animals, but with unsettling differences. Which brings us to the ancient elephants, particularly one massive species. Aside from some unusual skull features, this extinct elephant appeared similar to modern ones, especially from a distance. But if you approached one, you'd realise something was very wrong with its proportions, as this creature was absolutely enormous, and is now recognised as one of the largest land mammals ever discovered. Though paradoxically, it also includes some of the tiniest elephants known. And how can that be possible, you wonder? Well, this group contained numerous species that varied wildly in size. Most had disappeared by the late Miocene period, while the remaining ones mostly lived outside Africa, leaving just one species that early humans would have encountered. This particular species wasn't the biggest of its kind, but it was certainly massive, likely descending from one of the larger members of its family. And from the limited fossils available, it appears this species matched its predecessor's impressive size, which is remarkable considering recent estimates put these ancestors at over 13 feet tall at the shoulder, while weighing more than 14 tons, making it heavier than any predatory dinosaur and substantially larger than today's biggest elephants. So naturally, this size extended to their ivory as well. But even for such massive creatures, their tusks were extraordinarily large, as this group had the most extreme tusk proportions of any elephant, resulting in tusks that equaled the body length of smaller elephant species. These tusks were also less curved than typical and positioned lower, allowing them to easily strike at ground-level objects and interact with their environment, perhaps using them like ploughs in certain circumstances. And to make these giants even more formidable, those skull prominences I mentioned likely served a specific purpose, being attachment points for powerful muscles that supported their heads, thus allowing them to wield their tusks with increased force and velocity.
So you'd think any creature with sense would have understood not to challenge these titans. And yet, evidence suggests that early humans may have actually pursued them. While definitive proof remains elusive, we know that other human species in Europe successfully hunted similar-sized relatives using tools like spears, and we have throwing weapons by this time too. Now, if hunting occurred, it probably wasn't routine, considering these were the continent's largest animals, and any attempt carried enormous risks. And besides, there were numerous other large animals available that were both smaller and less dangerous. Though smaller doesn't necessarily mean easier, and a perfect example is the massive ancient cattle, commonly called the mega buffalo. Despite being much smaller than those elephants, this extinct bovine was still incredibly dangerous, and actually represents the largest cattle species that ever inhabited Africa, with adults reaching lengths of over 9 feet and standing nearly 6 feet tall at the shoulder. So basically taller than many modern large herbivores. They were also built with thick muscles and heavy bones, giving them serious weight, with bigger males regularly exceeding 2 tons, similar to today's largest rhinos. And when you make that comparison, remember that rhinos have incredibly thick protective skin, adding to their mass. Or this ancient cattle was essentially pure muscle, bone, and some keratin. as these creatures also possessed horns that would have impressed any animal, with each one extending sideways, being somewhat curved and extremely long, possibly stretching more than 3 feet each, almost like those of modern water buffalo to which they're related. And in bigger specimens, these horns might have spanned 9 feet from tip to tip, equivalent to a basketball hoop's height and longer than many dinosaur horns, including some from creatures nearly triple their size. So to support this bulk and massive frame, the giant cattle probably needed to consume vast amounts of vegetation, which combined with likely large herds, meant these animals significantly impacted their habitats, with their movements creating wide trails due to this behavior. They would have been relatively simple to track, enabling some of the more daring hunters, like perhaps humans, to pursue them. Though locating one was far easier than actually bringing one down, considering they weren't hesitant to employ their horns. Something we understand from actual historical records left by ourselves. You see, these cattle frequently appeared in cave paintings throughout Africa, which commonly showed them engaged in combat, usually with other bulls, with most displaying an aggressive posture, using their horns to charge opponents. And indeed, these battles were so frequent that they're the most common violent scenes depicted, strongly indicating that these cattle had quite an aggressive nature. It probably didn't hurt that they could likely reach speeds of 30 plus miles per hour, meaning whatever they hit, besides perhaps those giant elephants, was getting completely demolished. Naturally though, despite their massive horns, bulk, and aggression, this didn't prevent us from pursuing them, nor did it deter the others, and by that I mean other human species. As you probably remember, multiple Homo species have existed, but people often overlook that it wasn't a simple progression to us, with each species replacing the previous one.
Instead, there was considerable coexistence, which basically peaked during early modern human times. As, approximately 300,000 years ago, there were several Homo species inhabiting Africa simultaneously. Not necessarily in identical locations exactly, but close enough that encounters were possible. And along with sapiens, this included other species with varying characteristics, so quite a diversity. By this point, some had existed for hundreds of millennia, while we, conversely, were relatively new arrivals. And though all shared many traits with us, it's still unlikely that some were viewed as different by our ancestors, especially the more primitive ones. Certain archaic humans were fairly basic compared to others and resembled earlier ancestors, who were even more ancient hominins from which the Homo genus evolved. Like those predecessors, some had adaptations for climbing, as their body structure suggested a more tree-based existence and reduced efficiency for ground travel. They were also rather small compared to us, being among the tiniest humans known, and had correspondingly small brains, with no known tools or culture attributed to them yet, which possibly indicates a lower technological level that might have disadvantaged them against us or other species. Additionally, their diet seemed fairly basic too, consisting of tough foods gathered from the ground and covered in particles or grit, which shows in their heavily worn teeth. So it would have been obvious to modern humans that these individuals were quite distinct, but a much less clear distinction existed with the others, specifically certain species that were more widespread. While some species are known only from limited areas, others are found across various African regions, plus some eventually migrated from the continent too. Generally, they were quite similar to modern humans, matching our stature and possessing comparable brain capacity. Where they diverged though was in being more powerfully built, having broad torsos and strong frames that made them more resilient and probably physically superior to us. So let's just say in a physical confrontation between them and us, I know my prediction. At least they also possessed technology matching ours, with their sites regularly showing evidence of fire use, basic structures, spears, tools, and even artistic expression. And these innovations ultimately enabled them to spread widely, occupying a broad territory in Africa where they thrived on a diet heavy in meat, as they specialised in hunting big game. And this shared preference for territory and food could theoretically have created conflicts with Homo sapiens, where aggression might have resulted.
Although interestingly, there's a possibility that any encounters might have been resolved through communication, not conflict. Or rather, I should say, vocalizations, as research on their anatomy suggests they potentially possessed speech capabilities and had an early language form which would have facilitated cooperation. And certainly, some locations do show sophisticated teamwork, including one site featuring dozens of butchered large animals demonstrating their capabilities. And this capability probably extended to dealing with other humans too, making any interactions between them and us a fascinating subject, though currently no direct evidence of meetings exists.
But there is some research suggesting we might have interbred with certain groups in Africa. And actually, some researchers think they might be our direct predecessors, though this has received considerable criticism recently, but remains technically possible. Yet just one mystery among many. And like our uncertain relationships with other humans, another mystery surrounds perhaps the most intimidating primate ever, the giant baboon. Currently, it's unclear if this primate encountered sapiens, as fossils are extremely rare, and there's a possibility it disappeared before we emerged. But it was such a remarkable and terrifying animal that it deserves mention. And with a name translating to frightening ape, this primate was bigger than most humans, with some individuals weighing 16 pounds or more, and possessed surprisingly strong muscles, plus an enormous skull containing fearsome teeth, substantially larger than modern baboons' teeth. Fossil evidence comes only from limited African locations, where it apparently lived somewhat like baboons, mainly terrestrial and wandering the landscape rather than living in trees, thus making potential encounters more probable if timelines overlapped. However, unlike baboons and most relatives, this creature rarely consumed grass or savanna plants, instead focusing on fruits and possibly occasional meat, as scientists think it was an opportunistic eater, probably consuming more meat than most primates then. Additionally, given its size and dangerous teeth, some theorize that smaller, earlier humans might have been occasional prey, with the only positive being that our size and tools probably kept us relatively safe. And clearly, I don't want harm to our ancestors, but it would be fascinating if they truly coexisted with this powerful baboon. And besides this creature, there was another that matched its strangeness, though being less threatening, that absolutely lived alongside us. The prehistoric wildebeest. Yes, it appeared somewhat unusual compared to modern hoofed animals due to its elongated, thickened neck. But you couldn't identify its weirdness through sight alone. Instead, you'd need to listen, as while this creature didn't resemble a dinosaur, it certainly sounded like one. Specifically, a duck-billed dinosaur. When initially discovered, scientists observed that these animals had unique trumpet-shaped nasal cavities that were completely unlike other mammals, yet remarkably similar to certain dinosaurs. And honestly, its structure is so distinctive that scientists know no other creature except certain dinosaurs with comparable anatomy. The scientists studying this animal think they independently developed this feature due to similar lifestyles, as both inhabited large groups in fairly open environments, and therefore a special communication method would have been beneficial. Furthermore, both these dinosaurs and this wildebeest had highly specialized eating habits and teeth, which might have indirectly caused them to evolve distinctive skull features, thus producing their special nasal structures. And for this wildebeest, it's believed that they could produce sounds far below their regular range, achieving frequencies too low for human hearing, meaning they could literally be communicating loudly while remaining completely silent to us.
And perhaps this quietness made you eager for food. And I mention this because among the creatures discussed, this wildebeest is the sole one with confirmed evidence of human hunting, with remains discovered bearing butcher marks found alongside human implements. And how the group perished suggests humans probably hunted these antelope-sized animals collectively, with some theorizing that humans potentially caused their disappearance. And another creature that went extinct, though probably not because of humans, is one that initially looks quite recognizable, the ancient warthog, an extinct pig that could easily have been a movie character, as it appeared almost identical to modern warthogs, and indeed it's believed to be their direct predecessor. The main distinction, though, was this warthog-like creature was massive, with typical individuals matching today's largest warthogs, with most measuring roughly 5 feet long. And while impressive, where things become remarkable is their weight, because although modern warthogs can match their length, this ancient pig was incredibly dense, so dense that they could weigh double what similar length warthogs weigh now, with some calculations suggesting weights approaching 1,000 pounds in larger individuals, essentially a horse but warthog-shaped. And as you understand, warthogs can be somewhat temperamental and hostile, probably a common characteristic in this prehistoric pig, a prospect made worse because this creature possessed 4 tusks, which were relatively longer, more pointed, and straighter than modern ones, making their faces almost appear weapon-like. Similar to modern relatives, this pig probably employed these tusks for multiple purposes, including combat, so you'd certainly have preferred avoiding this creature, which was somewhat difficult since they inhabited much of the continent and were usually active, living, grazing existences. And this creature, plus the others discussed, weren't the sole recognizable species around, as then you also had various additional rhinos, zebras, and giraffes, but unlike this pig, they weren't especially enormous compared to modern relatives, though they did possess their own distinctive features. For instance, there existed a zebra species inhabiting regions that today lack any zebras. Then you had a giraffe, marginally taller than current ones, that also occasionally wandered beyond Africa, with many fossils actually discovered elsewhere. And then, most notably, you had a fuzzy rhinoceros, particularly one species found in northern regions. Unlike present day, this rhino inhabited northern Africa more than 200,000 years ago, and compared to modern rhinos, this one favoured somewhat cooler environments, which probably explained its thin, hairy covering that made it vaguely resemble woolly rhinos, though not quite as large, being more similar to current rhinos. And despite its name, you could find this rhino exploring forests and wooded regions, where we understand it regularly encountered humans. And how do we understand this, you wonder? Well, evidence shows humans have pursued large animals for countless millennia, including early modern humans. Numerous locations reveal proof of pursuing and processing this creature, including tool assemblages dated to roughly 250,000 years ago. It might seem unlikely that early people could have defeated such big creatures with basic implements, though through testing, these tools proved more effective than expected. Basic wooden projectiles can penetrate organs when aimed properly, while stone tips can even break through bones. By then, humans had created advanced stone implements attached to shafts and likely thrown. These individuals could have defeated any creature in their environment using proper tactics. There's also proof that we regarded this animal with particular significance and reverence, at least if we shared views with related humans, as this rhino occasionally became prizes for ancient hunters, with skulls being retained apparently as trophies. Interestingly though, while this creature shows extensive hunting evidence, research indicates its extinction around 35,000 years ago wasn't necessarily from excessive hunting, though like numerous Ice Age extinctions, it remains controversial. And this broadly reflects the pattern, because although various creatures disappeared from Africa during this era, they appeared destined for extinction regardless. And compared to other continents, Africa succeeded in preserving an impressive portion of its large animals, a key factor why early humans didn't encounter excessive strange animals, because frankly, the strangest ones remain alive, and let's attempt to maintain that situation. Thanks for watching.